Hey friends, this is Joy. So I decided to do another watercolor drawing sketch of a couple of zebras in my journal. And I sketched out ahead of time, just a quick pencil sketch. And here I am using my kneaded eraser to just remove most of the pencil from this page. I could still see it, but it's really light, and so that way I can watercolor it and be able to, you know, see the lines and everything, and it not show up once I'm done. And I just did a quick outline of, you know, and of both zebras, and then where, like, the main features were, the eyes, the nose, mouth, so that, you know, like I said, I have kind of a roadmap of where to color. So then when I going in here now with black watercolor, I just, you know, kind of go by, I just kind of wing it on the stripes and things like that. And I try to make sure that, you know, I'm going with the curve of the neck and those kinds of things so that it looks as realistic, you know, as it possibly can. And I'm not really getting a good dark color black with this watercolor that I'm using, but I do go over this, and you'll see a couple of times, to try to darken it. And then eventually towards the end I do pull out my colored pencils and my Prismacolor pencils to try to really deepen all of these black lines and add in shadow and those kinds of things for these zebras that I am drawing and painting. And I really, this is my favorite way, I guess, to do animal drawings, is to do them in watercolor and then come back with colored pencils. I really enjoy this, and it's a lot of fun. You know, I think it's a lot of fun to do it like this, and it really allows me to get a lot of depth and detail and those kinds of things as I'm working on these animal drawings / paintings. So you see here, I'm trying to go over the black again just to add more pigment and to deepen those lines in the zebra. And this probably took me about an hour to do, maybe a little bit longer. So yeah, I mean, it is a bit time consuming, but I was really happy with the results when I was done. And it's funny, you know, when you start getting into, like, the groove of it, it's like you just lose track of time. So, I mean, it didn't feel like that, you know, it took that long. But, you know, I mean, when I went back and put together, I didn't even realize how long it had taken me until I went back and put this video together to show the process. And then you can see, it's like, wow, you know, that took me a long time. And I'm like, nobody's going to want to watch an hour-long video. You know, that's just kind of ridiculous. I mean, I wouldn't want to watch an hour-long video. So, you know, that's why I tried to speed things up, you know, so that I can reduce this to a 20-minute video. So it's still kind of longer than I potentially would like it to be, but, you know, it is what it is. I wanted to be able to show the whole process with, you know, for this, but at the same time, you know, not make it so long. So tried to shorten it as much as I could. Now, when it came to doing the face and the lines and stuff on the face, that was a little bit challenging for me. Yeah, I mean, a couple of areas I felt like that I kind of goofed up. But in the end, I mean, I was happy with the final, like I said, results, because even if you mess something up, there's always a way to fix it in art. Or you can just leave it and decide that you're okay with it, because 9 times out of 10, even if you goof something up, nobody's going to notice unless you point it out. You know, that's what I've learned. I mean, there's things that, you know, times when people was like, oh, you know, I messed it up here, or I messed it up there. And it's like, well, I wouldn't have noticed if you didn't, like, point it out to me. So, yeah. It got pretty sketchy there on the head. The lines were really, you know, the stripes were really small and, you know, close together. And I'm just using this cheap water brush, which really, I mean, I probably should have just got a small liner brush that would have saved me, you know, some headaches there. But, yeah, I just continued on with this water brush, which, you know, probably wasn't the best thing to use for this. I probably made it harder on myself using this water brush than it really probably needed to be. But that's okay. Like I said, in the end, I was still happy with it, and I still enjoyed the process of creating this, you know, picture of the zebras. So here I'm, you know, working on the nose, and I'm trying to, as you see, have lighter colors where I water down the black to where it's a light gray, and then add darker colors. And so I'm trying to vary the intensity of the black, where it's, you know, goes from, you know, dark, you know, completely black to a dark gray to a light gray. And so that's one way of, you know, getting some variety out of your watercolors, obviously, is, you know, just to water it down. And so here I know that this baby is in shadow, so I'm doing a quick layer and a very light wash of, you know, light gray, which basically I just, like I said, added a bunch of water to a little bit of black, just so I can get, you know, some shadowing and gray in there. And again, when I go to using the color pencils, I will deepen a lot of the shadows. And like on the big zebra, there's no, like, shadows or anything on that one yet. But again, I do come back and try to add some shadowing, so that it looks, you know, more three-dimensional and not so flat, you know. But at this point, I'm just trying to get in the basic details of the two animals, and the striping and those kinds of things, and trying to, which I, you know, like I said again, was kind of struggling with, getting the lines, the black lines, as dark as I wanted them. But like I said, I never quite accomplished that with the watercolors. And so I did go in with some Prismacolor color pencils and got the darkness and the richness of the stripes that I was looking for. So here I'm just trying to get all these stripes in as best I can on the body, and then, you know, on the face here. And this, you know, face being even smaller made it even more challenging. Why did I not switch to just a little liner brush is beyond me. I have no idea. I guess I'm just a glutton for punishment. But you kind of get, you know, so focused and, you know, involved that, I mean, I don't know, it's like you just zone out. At least I do. So, I mean, I probably wasn't really, like, thinking, oh, you know, I need to, it would probably be easier if I changed to a different brush. But yeah, it was a challenge getting all those tiny lines in there and so close together. And yeah, so, but it, like I said, in the end, I was still happy with it. And yeah, here, I kind of goofed it up. And so I'm trying to fix it by, adding water and then blotting it up to try to blot up where I goofed that up. And so, yeah, continuing to try to put these little tiny stripes on the face so close together without goofing it up too much. But it kind of like, some of these lines kind of ended up somewhat running together. But oh well. In the end, it all turned out well. So, and it's still, I enjoy doing this and having fun and just practicing my animal drawings and paintings and stuff. I used to, when I was little, just draw all the time. I'd constantly be drawing animals and mostly horses because I was a bit of a horse fanatic. But now I just love, drawing all kinds of animals. And zebras are, I find, a lot of fun to draw with all the striping. I also like to draw, I have a lot of fun drawing tires because of all the striping and details and stuff I really enjoy, doing. And so it's just something I've always enjoyed doing, although I never did get into actually painting animals until quite a few years later. I got into oil painting when I was 18, with a woman that lived across the street. She would do oil paintings, and I would go over and do oil paintings with her, but they were mostly like flowers and vases and things. But I never, at that point, I guess, I don't know if I felt like that trying to paint animals would be too different or too complicated. But I never kind of got the desire to do that. So, at that time anyway. So, here I'm going over lightly with, some watered down black and trying to add some shadowing without messing up or activating the what I've put down so far and trying to give a little bit more definition. To these, and you can see me there on the mat trying to get the consistency that I'm looking for, because I don't want it too dark, I want it, to at least look somewhat, like believable or what have you. And so yeah, that's what I'm doing here, is I'm just trying to put in some of that shadow. And here on the little one's face, it almost completely obliterated all of the striping and stuff that I did on his face. But I was able to go back in with the Prismacolor pencils and stuff and fix that. But I just felt like that, it just needed, both of these just need a little more like definition and shadowing on the on them. So, because at first I believe when I was doing this, I was like just thinking that I would just do this in watercolor and then leave it at that. But I got to a certain point where I was like not getting the level of detail that I was looking for, if that makes any sense. And so that's when I was like, well, grab my Prismacolor pencils here and let's try to use those to help, with getting the darkness on the stripes that I'm trying to get and get the detail in these animals, that I'm trying to get. And so that helps a lot to, well, at least for me, because I'm so used to, you know, using pencils to draw animals to begin with. So for me, it's easier just to use the pencils to help with getting the detail and the definition that I'm looking for. So that's what I'm doing here. I'm just going through and trying to deepen and darken all of those black lines and get in, you know, details that I'm looking for. And so that's really helped. It's helping anyway for it to look better, I think. I have thought about, you know, you see people who use Prismacolor pencils to do drawings of different things. And I've thought about doing that, but it just seems like you have to put so many layers upon layers upon layers. I don't know if I'm up for all that. I'm a bit of a lazy artist. It's like, I don't want to have to sit and put layer, go over something, you know, like a half a million times just to get the depth that I'm looking for. I much prefer doing this process where, you know, I can lay down watercolor to get the main idea of it, and the, you know, the main part of it done, and then come in with the Prismacolor pencils and then go for, you know, getting more details. So here I'm just giving you a little bit closer up of me working on the face of these animals with the Prismacolor pencils and, you know, using a little bit of a white to lighten up areas that, you know, I felt needed to be lightened, and the black to darken areas that, you know, needed to be darker here on the nose and on the baby zebra here as well. And here I'm trying to make those lines on the face a little bit darker and crisper, because when I went over with the wash of gray, I kind of lost some of that definition. So in here I'm going to, you know, the body and adding some more shadowing and definition to the stripes on the body and the mane. And just trying to lightly do some shadowing there and working on the nose. And then of course going over with the white pencil to add a little bit of highlighting so that, you know, there's some definition, and you can see, like, on the nose of the baby, you can see where the nostrils are. And then, of course, trying to add the details into the eyes. So, yeah, I just kind of going back and forth trying to get the details that I'm looking for. And here is a white gel pen that I'm also using to do, like, little highlights in the eyes and help with that as well. So a gel pen's always a good, you know, good thing to use. And here I'm trying to use it, the white, to white lighten up some of the white highlights. So yeah, just working on it. Working on the nose and the body, and just continuing to go back and forth and work on different areas until, like I said, I'm happy with it. In some areas where I got a little too dark, I'm going in with the white and trying to lighten those up. So I'm almost about done here. I'm just trying to add a few more touches and highlights and shadows, and looking at it to see, is there anything else, you know, that I need to work on. And here I'm working on the stripes on the face. Because again, you know, when I went over that with a wash of gray, it kind of lost some of that, but then some of the lines kind of bled together. So here I'm trying to go over in between with the white to kind of bring back some of that division between the lines on the face. That was one of the things that, you know, I was not too happy with, because it seemed like everything just kind of blurred together. And so I'm trying to fix all of that. I'm continuing just to try to fix the lines on the face. But yeah, I mean, that's pretty much the drawing for today. I mean, if you guys want to see more, I would appreciate it if you leave me a comment and let me know. I really enjoy doing these animal drawings. If you like this video, I'd appreciate if you give me a thumbs up. And if you want to see more, you can subscribe to my channel to see more. I really thank you guys for stopping by and watching, and we'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.